Leader, this way.
Those things have popped up, so I can't sit on them.
Might not get down.
Here, Bob.
I want to tell you one thing about this trip. That I'm having framed. And I think it was done honestly from the demonstrators in London, but one of our guys found this. It's a big movie poster. Like that. And I'm having it framed because it's for Gone with the Wind. It's that scene where where Clark Gable is carrying Scarlett O'Hara. But they put my head on him and they put Margaret Thatcher's head on her. And I'm carrying her and it says the most explosive romance. And in the background then is a big atomic explosion behind us. It was directed by Hank Kissinger. Music was by, what's his name, Heath. The guy that's always jumping on her. And, what the hell were... Or some of the other things in there about this whole thing, but it really is great, and I just couldn't resist. I'm gonna bring it for the ranch, not here. I've got one that someone else did that's up on the third floor of the White House, and it's called Bedtime for Brezhnev. And that was a poster of a Western that I did, and there I am, but the villain is Brezhnev's face all in Western clothes and so forth. Well, I know we got some problems, and one of them I know has to do with the conflicts and the difference in the House version and the Senate version of the compromise. Good Lord, Howard, I hope our Senate stands firm because they just, I think, go in the wrong direction.
I think they'll stand firm, but I think that I feel fairly confident we can do that on virtually every issue. Maybe every issue. We stood firm on every issue on the Senate floor, and I think we can probably continue to do that. But the larger question in my mind is whether or not, in doing so, are we going to get any result at all or not? Let me say up front, I should have said at the beginning, I remain committed, as you would expect, to the representation that we all made in the cabinet room that we're going to defend this package that we agreed to, not only in the Senate, but in the conference as well. And we've done that. The Senate, I think, has been really remarkable in that respect. We had some tough days. But now the question, it seems to me, is whether or not we want to follow one course or a different one. One course would be to get the best deal we can and to see if we can sign off on it and go. That is the traditional way. And the other is to continue to stand pat and run the risk, almost the certainty, I expect, that you won't get a conference result at all. Frankly, as Dave Stockman knows from our previous conversations, as far as I'm personally concerned, and from the political standpoint, in terms of Senate Republicans and yours and the Vice President's campaign this fall, I've got a hunch, it's more an intuition than a hunch, but I've got a feeling that we might be better off just to...
Somebody seemed to think it was the other day. I had quite a splotch of gooey stuff here, somebody thought, I don't shoot ducks right here. Then I found out what it was, and it won't be regular, but it could be around here. When they have to come in like for the interpretation, and they tape the equipment under here. What I had was the residual of the tape that was pulled off. So we're gonna go. Keep your knees away from the bottom of the tape.
Mr. President, what's the device in front of you?
This is a big decision making help here. You see, if you can make any decision, then you can do that, and then you can say maybe, and get a little satisfaction, or no. And of course, the one I like best of all is Scram. Somebody sent me that, and I thought it was, this was the proper room for
it. All right. That's it.
Okay. Happy birthday. Issues. We have a complete agreement on all the basics, and even on the particulars of specific policies, there was much greater unity than the press would have us believe. There are one or two points in which there might have been a little blood on the floor, but it wasn't ours. Someone else's. Some of these other countries aren't coming out of the recession as rapidly as we are. This presents problems. But all agree that we must resist protectionist pressures, since that would lurk within a long time disadvantage to all of us. And I could also say that in the meetings there was really evidence of just direct inquiry of how had we done it, particularly with regard to unemployment. While we have added millions of new jobs, created new jobs in addition to putting the people back to work, and then lay off of the old ones, they have actually, and generally, lost jobs. They have a fewer number of jobs than they had before. And they really wanted to know. But if you look down at the figures, invariably, they are all of them spending a far greater percentage, or the government is taking a far greater percentage of the gross national product than we are in this country, which should teach us something. In Ireland, I made a point of speaking out against terrorist violence there, and was surprised that it was extremely well received by the Irish people. And also told them that we want to improve relations with the Soviet Union. I hope you all had a chance to see D-Day at Normandy. If you haven't, make a point to go there. There's nothing that is more moving. We started with Point de Hope, and to make George, having had a birthday, feel better, there were 62 the Rangers who climbed that 100-foot cliff, sheer straight cliff, on D-Day. 225 went up. 2 days later, there were only 90 left under arms in combat. But we met the 62 of them that were there, and one of them, 63 years old, the day before, they'd had an exhibition of our own modern-day Rangers going up that cliff to show how it was done. He joined them. He went up the cliff in 7 minutes. So, see? Then on to Omaha, and that one was the hardest emotionally, because prior to having talk or anything around the ceremony, we went over the chapel, and then we walked back, Nancy and I, through those 9,378 white crosses and white stars of David. And then you stand there looking at many were families and some were survivors. Finally, the big ceremony at Utah Beach with all of our forces there. But it was a worthwhile experience, and maybe some young people who've come along since World War II discovered that there was a lot of meaning to that. But now I'm going to call on George and Don in succession here to
Minister. It's good to see you again.
I feel very happy to.
Well, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President, for taking off the time from your very busy schedule to see you.
Very grateful.
And thank you very much, Mr. Thank you, Mr. President, for receiving us. I think it is an honor for me. And please convey my regards to your wife, Nancy.
I should do it.
Yes.
And that's George Bush.
Mr. Thank you very much for receiving us.
Mr. Minister, I think you're just the counselor right there, sir. Mr. Ambassador.
Oh, yes, please. Well, our visit was very enjoyable and productive in your country, and we're delighted to see you again and have you here.
We feel very happy to have come to the United States on a visit and continue our consultation on the issues of military technology cooperation upon the kind invitation of Secretary Weinberger. We feel honored today to be received by Mr. President and both my colleagues, my wife, and me will be honored.
present to you the officers of the Reserve Officers Association, yes. General Spartan,
yes,
the National President.
Nice to see you.
And Admiral Robert Spiro,
the
Executive Director.
Pleasure to be here.
And Colonel Eileen Bonner.
It's a pleasure to see you.
Nice to see you.
And Rear Admiral Olin Lively.
Mr. President.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Colonel
Mr. President,
Leo
how
Smith.
Do you do, sir?
Good to see you. Good to see you.
Mr. President, we need a photograph, if we could, with Admiral Spiro and General Barton on either side of you and the others. A group photo, if we could do that.
Right. Very happy to.
Thank you.
Perhaps.
Sir, do you want to come over between here?
Leo, why don't you fill in here?
Please
yeah.
Come closer. This is for the cover of the magazine.
Leo, right in here.
Come close this way. And if we could do a vertical, yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Right. Mr. President, General Barton was just promoted to general 2 weeks ago.
She said,
sir,
great pleasure to be here.
I thought you did too.
And thank you for all the wonderful things you've done for us in the military.
Did you do
we deserve the benefit from that as the new equipment comes in. Our own forces get modernized and we're appreciated.
I thought you were going to shoot the horizontal.
In history,
you didn't.
I did it both ways. The second lieutenant of the horse cavalry.
Yes, we're in the life member of our organization. I'm very, very proud of all the wonderful things that have happened during your time. It really has been good for the security of our country.
And that is why an active reserve is the most important part of our national security.
We'd like to think so.
Well,
I would think that the citizen soldier has been what has sustained us.
My own career proved that the Army does put down pegs and round wood. I was a second lieutenant of horse cavalry, one of the finding guests to the Air Corps.
That's right. We think you did pretty well.
You've heard
of the guest.
That's a pretty good desk to fly. That's a Emmy desk to fly. You do it very well, sir.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Yeah. See you down soon. I'll live there.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Take care.
Yes, thank you. May I present to you the Grand Exalted Ruler of the Elks, Mrs. Cantoli.
Yes, I'd like to be
Mr. Yothers, the past Exalted Ruler.
West.
And if we could take some photos, if we could take one with the two gentlemen together on either side of the president.
That would be from Iowa or Illinois if you said Dutch.
Yes. And if we could just, excuse me, just do one quickly with the Grand Exalted Ruler, Mr. Cantoli, and then we'll do another.
Oh, okay. All right.
This.
Right.
And then if we could do one with Mr. Yothers.
Right.
Mr. Cantoli, could we do just one with him?
Thank you.
Right. Senator Maxwell.
Oh, I know.
Very, very, yes. They're very happy with the Elks.
Yes. Well, my father was an Elk in Dixon, Illinois. And then the
Chairman of the Communications Committee was
a Dixon Elks Club had probably the only ballroom in town. And every year they used to have a dance for all the high school students. We always went to the Elks ball.
Yeah, we're showing that
we had something that we really showed that one of the communities of
75,000 and this and the money was all raised for the refurbishment.
Right.
We just handed it to ourselves.
$6,500.
$6 million. You know, the other day, Paul Harvey in Chicago did one of his broadcasts on Chicago. And all of the, some 750 programs now, the Planning Center, one of them for low cost housing. And I was just talking to him the other day. And couldn't get any bureaucrats on this. Maybe what we ought to do is have an inventory and find out if maybe this whole private sector thing that we started a couple of years ago hasn't taken hold so much that maybe there's some government programs that are totally unnecessary anymore. To find out if they're being done and done better.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much. Glad to meet you.
May I introduce my wife to you?
Thank you, Mr. President. So nice to meet you.
And this is my wife, Julie. She's a registered nurse in San Francisco. This is my daughter, Lori.
Hello.
She works for the office. And this is Dr. Scott.
Mr. President,
he's a surgeon at the Parkland Hospital.
Well, listen, why don't you and I get a picture, and then why don't we have a group picture?
All right.
Oh, nice.
Thank you, sir. Come on in. Survivors that are there. And one of them, a very big fellow, 63 years old, the day before, our present day Rangers scaled this 100-foot cliff to show how it was done. He went with him.
Oh, he did?
And he did it in 7 minutes.
The 63
year old?
He has proof he could still do it.
Well, best of luck to you and congratulations. Thanks for allowing us to meet you.
So glad it's a pleasure. I should tell you now I'm having a pain. And we had a fellow in show business, Moss Hart, the playwright.
Yeah.
And he was always very guilty of that. Go to a party, introduce animals, and being the type of doctor, and he started telling them about it. So one night at a cocktail party, he was introduced to a doctor, well, I'll say Jones, I don't remember the name now. And he immediately started him as usual. The fellow introduced him was embarrassed. It's Moss. Dr. Jones is a doctor of economics. And Moss said, I wasn't stock the other day. We were going to get some
of that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's coming to see you.
Designed it.
President.
Danny, hi. Well, how are you?
How are you?
Well, I've been looking forward to this. I appreciate you coming down with this.
Is your level?
Yes, it is. And the whole thing. The flags, the way it's balanced and all.
Do you think we've passed the test so far? 25 years.
Mm-hmm. Looks like the same guy designed that flag that designed the Union Jack, the president.
It is a British flag.
It is?
Well, the British had Hawaii for a while, and for some reason they abandoned it. The Russians had it for a while, and they gave it up also.
See how smart we were?
That's right. We were smart from way back when. You know, I'm giving two of my staff a special treat. This is my intern, Jennifer Gordon.
Hello there.
Dr. DeLeon.
Hello there. How are you?
Mr. Vice President.
Good to see you, sir. Why don't we all gather in and get a group picture with them?
You'll never forget this day, no?
Thank you, sir.
I thank you very much, Mr. President.
Well, we've always enjoyed our visits there.
Nice meeting you. Enjoy working with your boss. I'm doing a lot of matters. You appreciate your time.
Yeah, I'm not...
This is core, the wood that grows only more.
You didn't have that far.
What is it called?
Core. Came over in core. This means I love you, Mr. President. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you, Mr. President. You've got a couple extras. We'll get your signature along with the senator later on.
Good. And intern, if you'd like to do another that.
Stay with it, Paul.